You may want to think twice before lying. In one metro county, it could land you in even deeper trouble. The Cass County Sheriff's Office now using mobile fingerprint scanners. They're about the size of a cell phone and can ID someone in just minutes. I'm Pat McGonigal.
I'm Lauren Halifax. This is Fox 4 News at 10. Fox 4's Zach Summers got a look at how this works and explains why these devices are actually making it harder for criminals to deceive law enforcement.
So far, everybody that I've talked to about it loves the idea of it.
There's a new crime fighter in Cass County, and it can fit in the palm of a deputy's hand.
Any tool we can use to be more efficient, we're going to utilize that tool.
This is a mobile fingerprint scanner. The Cass County Sheriff's Office has been using them for about a month now, and they're capable of telling a person's true identity.
There are a great many people that commit crimes that don't like to either identify themselves or give false information.
Here's how it works. The device will scan your left and right index fingers. From there, the deputy will run that information through a criminal database where, if you've ever been arrested, it'll show your name, your date of birth, and a picture if available. If you've never been arrested, it'll be a no hit.
We don't drive down the street and see you walking on the sidewalk and make contact and ask to take your fingerprint.
Sheriff Jeff Weber says a deputy has to have reasonable suspicion or probable cause to stop someone.
And the courts have said if you refuse to provide identification, we can detain you as long as it's necessary to prove who you are.
The scanners, which cost about $1,500 each, are already proven to be more efficient.
I think it's a great tool.
Corporal Zach Weber loves the device. He says he can use it on the side of the road and get results in under a minute.
Before, I'd have to take him to jail, which could take up to 30 minutes just to get down here, fingerprint him, and then wait up to an hour plus to get back the results of who they are. So it cuts down time a lot.
Sheriff Weber says the scanners do not store people's information. He also wanted to assure the public their Fourth Amendment rights to an unreasonable search or seizure will not be violated.
That process has not changed. It's just now more convenient.
Now, I reached out to more than a dozen local law enforcement agencies in the metro to see if they use similar technology. KCPD, Blue Springs PD, and the Missouri Highway Patrol all confirmed that, yes, they have mobile fingerprint scanners, and they use them in some sort of capacity. It just kind of depends.
So are there other situations in which they might use these mobile fingerprint scanners?
Yeah, you know, I was talking to the sheriff in Cass County, and he was telling me about a situation in Belton just recently where there was a young man who had been shot, and he was incapacitated. He was unable to talk. So they brought one of these devices in, got his fingerprint, and they were able to identify who he was.
Wow. Right away on the scene.
So yeah, and you know, they only have two right now in Cass County, but the sheriff says that it's been so successful thus far that they want to get them in each patrol car.
All right. Okay, wow. Thank you.
Yeah. All right,